time, Lou.
Yeah, here we are.
Hold on. We're just gonna let him talk. Yeah, and then once we start.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We ask that you please rise and remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
Ready to start our finals.
Before we do, why don't we get the top five team scores here, Bill?
Well, I think we should go to the top six, because I think we got six teams that are going to finish with over 100 points. Sixth place right now, Eagle Academy with 96.5. Fifth place, Martin Luther King, 108.5. Fourth place with 123 is Tottenville. Brooklyn Tech is in third place with 142.5. Poly Prep is currently in second place with 150 points. And Monsignor Farrell currently leads with 158.5 points. Now, that's an 8.5 point lead for Farrell, but they've got one fewer wrestler in scoring position right now. So it'd be very, very close. It could come right down to the wire with Farrell and Poly Prep.
And how does it work? Let's tell the crowd. It's 4 points, I believe, for a championship win, Bill.
Right.
You know the bracketology here.
A win in the championship round is 4 points over what they've already scored. If they are to score a fall, it's an additional default or a disqualification or something like that. It's an additional 2 points. And if they were going to score a major decision is an additional point and a half, and I'm sorry, a technical fall is an additional point and a half, and then a major decision would be an extra point. So there's a lot of points to be had here in every match, and we'll see. We'll keep you posted as to how that team score is going as the day wears on, and I think we're in for an exciting finals.
Call someone?
So we're asking thank you before we were forced to remove you or ask you to leave the bleachers.
Okay, we're about ready to start our first final.
So we're here, Marino, Tottenville is a junior versus Lindblom, a sophomore from Fordham Prep. There are a few constellations that still do need to be competed though, Bill. I know that there's a couple of constellations still left there.
There's three more matches to go. Yeah, we were explaining that to the audience a little while ago.
So how's that going to play out?
Well, as soon as we'll add it to the team score, but they'll run those matches over there while the finals matches go on.
Won't interrupt the finals.
We'll keep our focus on the finals over here.
All right, so we're ready to rock here, it looks like.
About to find out who the best in the city is.
99 pounds.
Bella.
No, he has to stay there. So Marino in on a shot.
See if he can stay in bounds.
He's got two.
He's got it.
Two nothing here.
It's 2-0 in favor of Marino. Looks like Tottenville has some final singlets, huh?
Yeah, nice all black singlets. I know I've coached many years, the kids love it. They really do love putting on that final singlet, and win or lose in the finals, it's a nice feeling.
And our referee for this match is Tony Marsigliano. He's being assisted by our head referee for the tournament, Richie Martinez. You've seen those guys a few times,
yeah,
Tony.
Long time officials, great job. All part of the wrestling family. Lindblad here with the looks of what could be a reversal. He's in on a leg.
Looks like he's going to get at least one.
Nice duck.
Which he did.
Nothing.
No, still neutral.
That's some slick movement by Lindblad.
Nice move,
yeah, very, very, very good on his feet. What I know about Marino is a very, very strong wrestler. He's really worked on his technique in the offseason, but he is probably one of the strongest 99s out there.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely.
That's a nice thing.
I was watching him wrestle with in an earlier round, a semifinal round today with he just completely dominated his opponent. You get an upperclassman against a an older guy against a younger guy at this weight class, it can be very dominating.
And we're going to talk about rankings here. I believe we have Lindblad ranked number one and Marino number two. So
pretty good.
This is we should take a look at that and see how many times one and two came out. If Matt Deano, I know you're on the air. Is there a chat? Maybe you could post on the chat the Gotham City rankings as we're going through the finals. But I believe this is a one and the two. So congrats, ranking committee.
Okay. Okay, we got 15 seconds left in the first period. Marino's got a 4-1 lead. We'll go to the second period, and the official will toss the disc to see who has choice of position. Whoever wins the coin toss here, the disc toss, will ultimately get his choice of either starting from the top position, from the bottom position, from the neutral position, or he can defer his choice to the third period and let his opponent have choice in the second period.
Red choice.
Fordham wins the choice. He defers. And Marino chooses the neutral position.
So Marino took neutral?
Marino took neutral and he was deferred. Lindblom deferred to him and we went to, he chose neutral. Probably a pretty good shot. He had two good takedowns in the first period.
Nice spin behind.
Nice control of the hips too there. Did you see that where as he was spinning behind, he
elbow posted that down and
exactly.
I'm very impressed with Marino. He was good last year placed here, but he's much improved on his technique as well. And he's in control here. 6-1 with a minute 20 to go.
About halfway through the match, yeah. We're going to bring in another guest commentator with us. With me now for a little while is Joe DeForti. Not that Joe DeForti, Joe DeForti Jr., who's going to help us with the play-by-play here a little bit.
Hi, Bill. Thanks for having me. We have Joe Marino versus Tottenville and Stefan Lindbaugh, Fordham Prep, in our first finals bout here.
It's a 6-1 now in favor of Marino in the second period. So, it's a good way to start off the tournament, isn't it?
Yes, very good. Exciting match, Lindbaugh.
So Joe, tell us a little bit about how you came to be part of this little broadcast team here.
They posted something on Facebook about it, and I responded, and they asked me to send a video of some of my commentaries on a couple college matches.
Great. What college matches are you looking at?
Well, Ed Ruth versus Gabe Dean in the finals of the Southern Scuffle. Gabe Dean upset Ed Ruth, number one ranked, returning national champion. In 10th place with 62
points. So take us through this match, isn't
it? About 29 seconds left in this second period. Fordham Prep Stefan Lindbaugh is down 6-1 to Tottenville's Joe Marino. As the clock runs down, it looks like Marino's going to ride him out. He's got a padlock in, he's rolling up those arms. 20 seconds left.
So you wrestled in this tournament today too, didn't you, Joe?
Yes, I took sixth with two losses at the end, but I ended the weekend 3-3.
Not a bad weekend.
No, it was not.
And you're looking forward to, I assume, to the city championships coming up.
Yeah, that'll be coming up next month.
Okay, as we get into the third period here, it's 6-1 in favor of Marino of Tottenville over Lindblom of Fordham. And Lindblom chooses the top position to start the third period. Interesting. That's an interesting choice, isn't it?
Yeah, especially down by 5 points. You think you want to go neutral or bottom. Try and get a quick score.
Well, it tells you something about what he thinks of his ability.
Yep. I guess that backfired on him a little bit. Quick escape by Joe Marino. That makes it 7-1.
So this match won't have a terrific effect on the team score at all. Tottenville's in fourth place, but they're really not in striking distance of moving into third. And they're pretty safe in their fourth place already. Fordham is down there a little bit. They're down in seventh place. So this is not one of the matches that will have a big impact on their final team scores.
But it does help show how far Tottenville's come from last year to this year.
Yeah.
Very big turnaround. Going from a not very dominant team in this to top four, which is a great accomplishment.
Absolutely.
And
we've been hearing similar comments from everybody who sat down here about how impressed they are with how
Coach Sean and his assistant coach has done a terrific job down there, obviously. Yeah, a lot of place winners.
Sean used to be one of your coaches, no?
Oh, yeah. He coached back last year, and for a while he was a great guy. Coached me all through middle school. Love Coach Sean, yeah.
And who are your coaches now?
Coach Dave Ola and my dad Joe DeForti Senior. Who, we're doing good. We finished right behind Tottenville and Cities in the island this year, and be heading into playoffs next week. So we're all excited.
A little family affair over there.
Yeah, a little bit. Hopefully we can get Mike in there, and then with about 40 seconds left in the third period, Marino's up 7-1, and Limbaugh is just trying to get some points on the board here. Out of bounds again, 30 seconds left. Stephen Limbaugh's got to work something here, try and get some. And looks like he's got a takedown, but no. Stephen Limbaugh's trying to hip up. Marino's cutting the corner. Elevating, cutting the corner, still neutral. Running out of time, 5 seconds left. Time.
We've got our first Mayor's Cup champion, Joe Marino of Tottenville. Score 7-1 at 99 pounds.
Good match.
Now we're going to move right into the 120-pound match. That's our second match as soon as this match is over. But after that, every other match, we're going to be having an awards presentation in between matches. So why don't you introduce our 120-pound finalists here?
Our 120-pound finalists are Daniel Amico from Martin Luther King High School and Kyle Morsey from Martin Luther. These were the 1 and 2 seed ranked in their weight class.
And Amancio is the defending champion.
Yeah, so it looks like we're going to have a good match today.
Should be a good one.
Yeah.
Referee for this match will be Rich Rinaldi. He'll be assisted by Peter Hamm.
I wrestled both of these guys earlier in the season. Both of them are very aggressive right out the gate.
Oh, so this is your weight class?
Yeah. And Amancio gets a quick two and lets him up. Morrissey dives at it again. So right now it's 2-1, about 15 seconds into the first period. Morrissey dropping on a shot, pumped off. Morrissey drops, Amancio spins, and that's two for Amancio. Morrissey.
Pretty good takedowns already.
Yeah. But, very defensive. He hasn't taken a shot yet. So, he's been working off Morsey a little bit here. Up 4-1 with about 1:05 left. Morsey stands up right off the whistle. He's up on his feet. They're aligned. And Morsey escapes. That'll make it 4-2 with a minute left in the period. Morsey's on that head. as they circle back. Morsi's rolling up a wrist and on. Little arm drag there.
Drag single there, yeah.
Nice. Nothing yet, though. Morsi on his back.
Trying to pass that leg through.
Yeah. He's trying to get on the side. He's got a reverse lock on that leg. He's not trying to padlock it.
That's one of those rules that came into play the last couple of years when you've got that, what I call crazy leg in.
Yeah, miracle in. And it looks like he's getting back points
yes,
here
he
now.
Is.
Amancio trying to hip up. Now with the takedown and back points, it looks like Amancio will be up, was it, 9-2. So, with 5 seconds left in this period, Morsi's dug himself a hole going into the second period.
So is this broadcasting thing something you might like to do as a career someday?
Well, yes. It's always been a fun thing that me and my little brother like to talk about during because we're big sports fans, so we love all that stuff.
Well, outside of wrestling, what's your favorite sport?
Football, probably.
Okay. So Morsi won the toss and deferred to Amancio, who chose the bottom position.
He hasn't been on bottom all match, so let's see how he does from here. Right off the whistle, he tries to stand up. Morsi's breaking him down now. He's got a rebar in. He's trying to run it around the head, and he's flattened him out. He's basing, Amancio's basing back up again. They're on the edge of the mat now. Morsi's still got that rebar in. Looks like Mancio's trying to hit a switch here, and now he's standing up. Morsi's got a tuck still around the waist. Morsi's been hit with a stalling pull.
Right, by rule, you've got 5 seconds to try to bring your opponent to the mat once he's on his feet, so that's what happened there, is that he wasn't able to bring him to the mat. In 5 seconds, wasn't really attempting to break
the
bounce.
Yeah, more trying to pull him out of bounds. So with about 1:30 left in the period, Morsi's Amancio, my bad, still up by 4. So, Morsi trying to throw legs in here. He's flattened him out. He's looking for a power half now. Getting a little high there, though. Amancio trying to seatbelt and face him. Morse, and he'll hit a reverse.
There's a reversal.
Yeah. Amancio now up 11-2.
Oh boy, he got his nose a little close to his knee, didn't he?
Yeah. Cradle locked up. Looks like he's going to try and stud him here. We're on the edge of the mat.
Referee holding a 3 count.
Yeah. Oh, and
there's something that most people don't realize if they're not following wrestling a lot. It's not the shoulders that cause it, but it's any place along the shoulder blade, the scapula. If they're both down, it's a fall. And that's what you saw there. It's a situation where the lower part of Morrissey's scapula were... Okay. So we're going to move to the award stand for a little bit. Hey, Joe, thanks for being part of this thing. And come back and visit us a little bit later on. Okay. Guess we're not going to... So I can tell you what I do the awards. I'll be all right.
How's it sound? Yeah.
Oh. The presenter of the Ironman Clown Individual Awards is representing the PSAL, Mr. Donald Douglas. The eighth place at 99 pounds, Jonathan Durano, 50 yards. Seventh from Fort Smith, Arthur Potter. Sixth, Joe Lang. Fifth from Grand Street, Rafael Valdez. Fourth from Xavier, Danny Hatch. Third from Marshall High School, Manny Gonzalez. Second place from Fort Smith, Stefan Lindblom.
Okay, we've got out there right now, we've got Lenny Merkin of Poly Prep and Chris Martorello of Fordham Prep. This is a match that could have some bearing on the team title, and Merkin tries a little throw in there and almost scores with it, and over the line they go. We're a minute into the first period, and the score is still at 0-0.
Head to the staging area, please return to the panel, place winners to the staging area. Thank you.
Merkin in with a really nice single leg. Real good counter by Santoro. This scramble is anybody's. And there's a takedown. Merkin has Santoro on his back, but he gets off. So Merkin now leads 2-0. Down to the final 20 seconds of the first period. It's still 2-0. Merkin's still in control. 10 seconds left in the first. Okay, your referee in this match, by the way, is Mr. Paul Boscia. He's assisted by Tony Marsigliano. Okay, Santoro wins the toss, defers to the third period, and Lenny Merkin will choose the bottom position to start the second period. Merkin working on that arm over the top of his shoulder, trying to create some space between him and his opponent, see if he can get out. Santoro doing a great job of maintaining control. There's a Granby roll attempt by Merkin, countered really nicely by Santoro. And Santoro remains in control. Now they're neutral. Merkin with a one-point escape. He leads 3-0 with a minute and 19 to go in the second period. Work for the takedown now, both guys. Nice attempt by Santoro, countered really well by Merkin. Beautiful duck under. Merkin was ready for it, and he countered right away and was not taken down beyond reaction time, so there was no takedown. Okay, let's see how they score this. Merkin, Santoro inadvertently managed to get a finger into Merkin's eye. That caused him to kind of lose control of what was going on out there. So referee correctly stops it as an injury, and so there's no point scored there. So Joe DeForti Jr. was with us there for a while. I've got Lou DeStefano's back. He just came from coaching one of those third place matches. How'd it go over there?
Springfield Gardens came away with the win. It was 2-2, and he caught a nice bar and pinned our guy.
Oh, Merkin with
here.
A pancake.
This would be nice fall here. Big implications.
Big
for
team
a fall.
Score implications here. Big implications.
The fall.
So he's got his count. He's got his count.
Santoro fights off pretty hard, though.
Well, while you were on your way over here, Santoro hit a duck under and Merkin countered it. It was two of the nicest moves in a flurry that we've seen in a long, long time. No points scored, but what a beautiful shot by Santoro and a beautiful counter by Merkin.
We got two sophomores here, Bill. Isn't that something?
Yeah.
Pretty high level of wrestling. These guys are both pretty decorated youth wrestlers.
Yep.
They've been around, schoolboy state champs. So these are not your traditional high school guys, but both competing in New York City. Merkin up 8-0 here.
Start of the third period.
Yeah. As a coach of Lenny, I'd like him to keep the pressure on. You know, you have your guy up 8-0. Lenny's probably as explosive as they come, and just keep pressing. Keep pressing.
I think these guys will see each other a few times over the years. What do you think?
Yeah, they wrestled in the dual meet. They wrestled in the Mayors Cup final. I know Santoro is ranked pretty highly in the Catholic states, probably top three guy at least.
Nice little flurry there. Santoro looked like he was about to get out. Merkin really keeps the pressure on him and remains on top.
I mean, so coming into this match, Farrell still has an 8.5 lead over Polly. If Murphy can hold on to this, that would be 4, and the major
another,
being an additional
point,
1.
Yeah.
So closing the gap, and then if that happens, it'd be 4-4 left.
Ooh. It's going to be an interesting afternoon.
Santoro looking for a switch here, though.
Merkin's still hanging on to control because he's got that leg. This is an important
Uh-oh.
Couple of points here if
yes.
he gets them.
That's Merkin's best position on his hips. Gets Santoro's back.
Well, he fought off that switch really well. Santoro's getting close to getting an escape here. I think he's got it. Yep, there's the escape. We have 18 seconds left in the third period.
What, 18 seconds here. If Lenny can get a takedown. And Santoro's in on a shot. Lenny is fantastic from this position, though. I will tell you, he's got some of the best hips I've ever seen. Fights it down. Looks like it's going to just end 8-1. With a victory for Merkin at 132 pounds.
So Polly picks up 4 points. So that narrows the gap to what, 4.5?
4.5.
4.5 points separating Polly Prep from defending champion, 8-time defending champion, Monsignor Farrell. Lenny Merkin is your champion at 132 pounds. Okay, we're going to move to 145. Carl Wiesner from Farrell and Ronaldo Rodriguez from Zverian. Farrell going to get a chance to regain those 4 points, I guess. He is the top seed.
And Wiesner has a cradle, as you know. He's been in it since kindergarten.
Unbelievable.
Cross face cradle. And he is as strong as they come. Cole recorded a pin versus St. Anthony's the other night in the dual meet Friday night. Nice bumped up to 152 and hit a crossface cradle. And
really?
Scored a 6, yep.
Well, Rodriguez is a bit of a surprise here, isn't he?
I don't really think so. I think he put in a ton of offseason work. He pretty much lived. Nice shot. Pretty much lived at the training center. Freestyle and Greco. He's clearly an athlete.
Okay.
And I think he's just catching up.
What grade is he in now?
He's an 11th grader as well.
Okay. Your referee in this match is George Cabrales. He's assisted by Tony Marsigliano is the assistant referee here.
Second, 120 pounds, Martin Luther, Kyle Morrissey, and your 120 pound Bears Cup champion from Martin Luther King, Daniel.
So Rodriguez is working his underhook on the feet here, seems to be controlling the tie on Wiesner. Wiesner is a more of a counter wrestler than an offensive kind of guy. Very difficult to take down and very good on both positions on the mat.
Absolutely, and as you've said, he's been wrestling a very long time.
Yeah. And one of the great things about Call is he loves it.
Looks like we're a little off on our score.
Oh.
We have Farrell in the lead with 160 and a half, and Polly Prep with 154.
Now that's inclusive of the 132 pound final?
That's as of right this moment, yeah.
So four guys each, 6.5 points.
That's very doable for anybody. That's a doable thing. So we're down to the last 15 seconds and no score. It's been a pretty good first period. A lot of give and take, huh?
Rodriguez is tough. I mean, he just gets better. You know, wrestling at Xavierian, Michael Polo and Renee Barrow have done a good job resurrecting that program. They were really down to just a few guys, and now they got quite a few placements here.
And we're down to our last couple seconds of the first period. We'll see what happens as we move into the second.
So Ronaldo starting out on top. Got a leg in. He's looking for a crossface cradle. Wiesner looking to reverse it. In on a leg. In on a single now. And Call gets his two. Navy ride. If he elevates this, he'll get some backs. And he couldn't hold on to it. But a nice 2-0 reversal for Call. Right to his padlock. And I can all but guarantee a crossface cradle will probably be coming in here.
At the very least, an attempt. Oh, look, just a half Nelson button.
Half with a nice wrist. He's in a lot of good wrist rides at the high school level. He's going to put this on the back. This is a hammerlock that he's going to try to push this across the body, get that padlock. Rodriguez has really got to keep that hip away. If Call pulls that out, we have some trouble here.
Minute left here in the second period. It's 2-0 Wiesner.
Throwing in the boot now.
Do we know if these two have met during the course of the year yet?
Oh, here we go, cradle. Oh, a little high. Call's a little high. They did. I believe Call did win in the dual meet. Uncertain of the score, but Call is the number one seed in this tournament, so he would have the head-to-head. Rodriguez really needs to get this one this period.
That was a nice lift.
Yeah. Crowd loves it. Not a lot of point value, but fun for the fans.
It's one of those ooh-ah moments, you know?
Yeah. Still impressive. So with 2-0 going into the third, does Rodriguez challenge? He goes neutral.
He takes neutral. Interesting.
Yeah, just got ridden out there. He doesn't want to waste time.
He had that real nice body lock towards the end of the first period, so maybe he's thinking if he can get something like that closer to the center of the mat, he might have a shot for some big points.
Yeah. Yeah, he's working that underhook.
Good thought, but he didn't clear the head. Whoa! Oh. And a fall, a very quick fall.
Big pin for Carl Wiesner.
and for Monsignor Farrell.
Well done, Carl. Well done. Two-time Mayor's Cup champ, Carl Wiesner, two-timer.
Carl Wiesner.
Kind of happy for Carl.
Yeah. Carl's come a very long way.
Next up, the 152-pound final. From Eagle Academy, Nigel Williams.
This one could be a barn burn.
Yeah, I don't know a ton about Safar. I hear good things, but Nigel's one of the top guys in the city, though, between all the weights. You think Safar's at that level?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And so now we've got Nigel Williams of Eagle Academy and Zafar Iskandarov of Brooklyn International. Both were members of the New York State team. Both were members of the New York State team to the Junior Nationals.
Oh, what happened? It looks like we have a score.
Oh, he's going to. Okay. It looks like we've got an injury default.
Yeah.
I do know that Nigel got hurt his. I know that Nigel hurt his ribs in the previous match. So I guess we're going to move to 160.
Yeah. That's unfortunate. But, you know, coming into the postseason, you really can't be.
You can't take that chance with ribs. No. You just can't take the chance with ribs.
It's just rest.
Yeah. There's nothing really much you can do to protect them, you know, or to heal them. It's not like you put a cast on your ribs, you know.
No.
Well, now present the award for the 132-pound weight class. Presenting the individual awards is Mr. Mike Kovacs, Chairman of Beaton Streets.
Forfeit, medical.
And his play is from A.P. Randolph and Eastern Cumbia. Second from Brooklyn Tech, Chris Kerr. Sixth from Monsignor Farrell, Austin Pettis. Fifth from New Utrecht, Swan Jen. Fourth from Dalton,
all right, so this is one of the ones we've been looking forward to, isn't it, Luke?
Yep, this is a one-point decision in the round play of the Grapple at the Garden, Thanksgiving weekend, which seems an eternity ago now.
Doesn't it seem like a long time ago? Konstantin Parfuryev of James Madison and Camila Gaetan of Brooklyn Tech.
Two seniors, two defending PSAL champs, and, you know, we're going to have one Mayor's Cup champ and one going to states eventually late in a few weeks, so.
Yeah.
Should be interesting.
And again, you've got the officiating team of Rich Rinaldi on the whistle and Peter Hamm as the assistant.
That's some crew. Parfiev placed up at the Easterns.
He did. He did. Eastern States is a hard place to place. And he was one. He was also sixth in the New York State Championships last year. It'd be a shame if one of these kids didn't get to go to the States, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it looks that way. I mean, I can't imagine anyone shifting weight classes.
I would think if Konstantin were to be the runner-up at the city championships, he'd have a shot at a wild card because he placed last year. Not a great shot, but a shot.
Yeah, I'm not sure how that works with PSAL and CSSA. I know it gets always a bit different, but
yeah. We've never had the situation before.
No,
we've had a place winner who didn't repeat as the city champion. So
it wouldn't be that big of an upset here. I mean, clearly Konstantin is the favorite. Nice double there.
Nice double. Two-point takedown by Parfiryev.
I mean, I know Coach Campbell seems nothing but high praises for Konstantin. He's really been a big part of Madison being a, you know, top team in the PSAL for basically year in, year out.
Yep.
You know, top in the playoffs, at least the semifinals, the quarterfinals at a minimum.
Well, they've won this tournament at one point in time in terms of the overall PSAL score. Yep. We give out special awards to the top placing CHSAA, PSAL, and independent school team leaders, you know, highest point scorers. And we do that because, Lou, you remember back when this thing was started, really the brainchild of the three leaders of those three divisions. Jim Regan from the independent schools and Martin Luther. Larry Cantor is the commissioner of the PSAL back then. And Bob McLaughlin, who just sent me a text message, by the way, saying he won't be here for the final. So Bob McLaughlin, the athletic director at Fordham Prep, who were the founders, he was a coach at Fordham Prep at the time as well, and they were the founders of this Mayor's Cup, and that's why the three divisions have always remained as members of the committee. You know, Parfuryev is starting the second period down. Let's see if he can add to his lead here.
Yeah, 3-0.
And he does with an escape.
Let me look at Thompson from Brooklyn Tech. It's a season record of 21-6 and overall record of 76-22. His runner up the division.
So the third place bouts are complete.
We have the 145 pound.
We've got a on our team scores at this stage of the game. Not a lot of change. No change in the order of team scores. Eagle Academy with 96.5, MLK with 116.5, Tottenville with 127, Brooklyn Tech with 142.5, Poly Prep with 154, and Farrell still in the lead now by 12.5 with 166.5 points. And there's another takedown for Parfuryev.
Really, I mean, Farrell, that Wiesner pin was tremendous. Polly's going to need to score bonus and go 4-for-4 or 5-for-5. Merkin's done, so they got to go 4-for-4 with bonus. And, you know, you have Matt Seitz, who's probably the favorite at 126, and Hassan as well. So a lot of wrestling left to do.
Nice.
Pretty change crossover there. Really caught it tight. That's backs. That's got to be some back points here. He can get the full.
He's really got a good shot at the full. He's got that really tight, doesn't
he? Yeah, he's got his head. You know, Gason was
20 seconds
out.
Left. That's an eternity when you're on your back in that position.
Oh, boy, yeah. I mean, he's got to just drop his hip, get that leg free, and, you know, Gason's fighting, but it looks like it's coming to an end right here.
We're down to 8 seconds.
Gation coming up. Look at him.
He's
going off. Well done.
Here's the updated standings of the top five column, the 152-pound. With 116.5 points.
Okay, so Gaetan chooses a neutral position to start the third period. Probably a pretty good choice.
Yeah. Constantine has definitely separated the gap from the early season meeting. Not surprising. I mean, he's an all-state wrestler. He's a state placer. And sometimes those matches are as early as Thanksgiving, which we're really not used to. Don't always remain the same later in the year.
That's after the 152.
It's an interesting dynamic about Brooklyn Tech. A great team. I still say the favorite to the PSAL duels, but no outstanding guy. Really, just every kid is solid.
That's right.
And they should take that as almost as a compliment, that they can get every wrestler in their room to a solid level, which is so hard.
And they're 2 and 3 deep in every weight class.
Yeah. And they've had state place winners. I mean, so, you know, the past couple of years, Christian Messiah, Patrick K, a 220-pounder.
Kupczynski.
So they've had their state place winners. This year, it just seems that they're just balanced as can be.
Yeah. They're a great dual meet team. And I think they're pretty young, too, if my memory serves me correctly. We got another Brooklyn Tech kid coming up in our next match, too. So another nice shot. Oh, nice counter.
Constantine looks incredibly impressive here.
He's turning up. Turned it up a notch. It up a notch this late in the season. And this is the right time to be doing it, too, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, I think the PSAL has to be pretty excited about his chances up in New York State.
Yeah.
And being a returning place winner, you would think that he'd be pretty highly seeded as well, which in New York State is absolutely critical to go in seeded as opposed to unseeded.
Those seeding points are so important because the difference between losing in the first round and having to wrestle back to place and losing in the second round and wrestling back to place is two fewer matches.
Yeah.
And if you You gotta win.
And you're going through bus stores.
And there's no easy matches in there. That's going to do it. It's 10-0, the final score for Konstantin Porfiriev. Quite a difference between the earlier meeting back around, as you said, around Thanksgiving. Yep. Quite a difference.
160
pounds, 2014 Bigger Cup champion.
Constantine for Fred. Next up is the 182 pound final for Brooklyn Tech, Ben Pindesh, and from Wingate, Aleke Cunningham.
Okay, so Brooklyn Tech, look at that uniform.
Yeah, that's a new singlet. Must be that final singlet. Camilla didn't have
camouflage,
it on.
Huh? Yeah. Blue and white camouflage and gray. And look at this, a red uniform for Wingate.
Yeah, they were traditionally blue.
It's an interesting story. When they first started the team, the order was placed incorrectly for the uniforms. The Wingate is a red, I mean, their colors are red and black. And the order was put in for blue. The blue uniforms came, and they stuck with it. So it looks like they're making the transition to the red uniforms.
Yeah.
Billy Patton.
Nice shot off the whistle.
Beautiful.
By Cunningham.
Yeah.
And to a cradle. Can we get a quick pin here? Wow.
He's got him.
That is pretty nice.
It's a long time if he doesn't get out of bounds, I'll tell you. There it is.
17-second pin for Cunningham.
17-second pin for Malik Cunningham of Wingate. Really put it together for that match. And now he's going to have to go shake hands with his former coach at Wingate, Steve Flanagan. Probably some real mixed emotions over in that corner, huh?
Yeah, I mean, you know, most coaches, if you coach them at one time, you're going to be happy deep down. Not celebrating externally, but
yeah,
you're...
We're going to get a hug there, I think.
Yeah, nice tap on the back.
It's an interesting sport. Okay, so 182's in the books. That didn't take very long. No way, that was... this one could be good. This one could be good.
Yeah, so we have Nathaniel Rose, a junior. Mike Newman, a junior from Farrell. And two big boys.
Yes, yes. There's a pretty strong, a lot of strength out there on the mat here.
Yep. One thing you might not know about Mike Newman, he is hearing impaired, so the referee will need to tap him to advise of the stoppage of wrestling. It by no means slows him down.
No, it doesn't. And I hope they're going to tell his opponents so that something weird happened out there.
Yep. He and his brother both wrestled, similar experiences, so most are familiar. And this is a matchup that's been waiting for some time.
Yeah, Nathaniel's had quite a last season, this season, off season. He's done a lot of wrestling.
Yeah.
He's part of the Fargo team, the New York State Junior National team.
Mike Torriero joined
Mike
us.
Mike Torriero is joining us on the on our
what'd
webcast.
What did you think of that last quick pin there, huh?
Did you blink?
I saw it. I definitely saw it. I think that Nathaniel Rose is one of the top prospects in the country for this weight. I'm excited to see him wrestle right now.
He's in a nice shot to begin with, that's for sure.
For the pipe.
Wow. Yeah, Rose is definitely one of the top guys in the city. All right, I'm going to step away because I got a couple of wrestlers.
I'm going to step in, but we've got one of our, somebody else who knows just about every kid in the city. Mike Torriero is joining us, former head coach at Beat the Streets. How you doing, Mike?
Doing very well. It's a great tournament. Setup's great. Crowd is great. New format this year seems to be working. Everyone seems happy.
Yeah, it looks that way.
Yeah, it looks awesome.
Yeah. Another match that could have some implications on the team score if Farrell were to win it. Nice lift by Rose. And he's going to cut him. Escape for Mike Newman of Farrell.
It's a freight train.
Yeah, that was a great takedown. You're right, freight train. It's about the old way you describe something like that.
Nathaniel was down at the New York Athletic Club the other day, and he was hitting double legs, and we had to have small children move out of the way because they would have got ran over.
Looks like we could have another quick pin here. There it is. There it is. Another quick pin and Nathaniel Rose.
Should we say Tampa's here?
He's got a shot, man. He really has a great shot.
It's only a junior. Cooley's doing
both of them.
Ryan Cooley, ex-coach at Mount St. Vincent, is over at Eagle Academy now helping out with John McGarry, and the program is just fantastic.
Yeah. Eagle's a small school, too. Eagle's a very small school, and these guys have a shot. They're coming back-to-back here at 95 and 220. We're on the 220 Mount final. Martin Luther King, Nashville, Peacock.
Right now?
I really hope.
I think they are.
No, this is the
before we get to the 220-pound final, we're going to present the Mayor's Cup Volunteer of the Year Award. This will be presented by...
While we're waiting for this final, we're going to present the John Welch Volunteer of the Year Award. It's going to be presented to one of our city, great city, Bill Christensen of Sheepshead Bay, who has really helped keep Sheepshead Bay and New York City wrestling. He's been a terrific for the last 10, 20, 30 years, and does it all out of the goodness of his heart.
He really does. Yeah, I didn't know he's 70 years old.
What's that?
I didn't know that he's over 70 years old.
Yeah, he's retired. Okay, we're gonna check in for our 220-pound match. We've got Desmel Peacock of Martin Luther King and Miguel Perez of Eagle Academy.
I get an MRI tomorrow.
So it's back-to-back entries for Eagle Academy, Mike. What do you think? From Martin Luther
King. Yeah, I mean, great wrestlers come in pairs, so it's no wonder that if Nathaniel Rose is competing well, it's because he's got a good workout partner in Miguel.
Martin Luther King's made some real strides this year, haven't they?
They have. They've had a good program for a bit, and Danny Amancio is really kind of leading the charge from the student body standpoint, and they got a good program. They're up by Lincoln Center. Schools in a nice community.
Yeah.
Easier to change the mindset than some of the places that are in deep Brooklyn and the Bronx.
The referee for this match is Tom Favell. It's the first we've seen him on the mat this evening. He's being assisted by Rich Rinaldi. Did you know that Miguel, as only a junior, is the president of the entire student body at Eagle Academy?
I did not know that, but I know that I went to run through same way. I went to Eagle Academy for career day, and he had a big leadership role in getting the volunteers that were in to speak about their careers and everything else. He kind of led that charge, and he did a great job at it.
Yes. This is going to be close. Now they got a lot more of them in bounds, so this could result in a takedown for someone. Yeah. If he goes a little head hunting, there you go. 2-point takedown for. Miguel Perez, so. We've got about 30 seconds left to go in the first period. Perez leads 2-0. He's got him on his back. A little tilt up there. He's got back points. This question on the 2-point, two back points for Perez. It's that time where we give away the 2 free tickets for January. Well, looks like he's getting ready to turn it on, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does. Look at the lift. I'm going to step away.
Okay. Mike, thanks for joining us here.
Great seeing you, Bill.
Chris Gregorio. Chris Gregorio is in the building. Please head on over to the University Mayor's Cup Facebook table. It's over behind the staging area. By the entrance are the American flag. Chris Gregorio, congratulations on winning 2 tickets.
Okay, we're starting finishing up the period. Joining me now is Jim Regan, the principal at Martin Luther High School, one of the founders of the Mayor's Cup, the host of the first Mayor's Cup. So, Jim, welcome to our broadcast, our webcast.
Thank you very much.
So, what do you think so far?
Well, I tell you, we've come a long way in 11 years. We certainly have moved it up. The level of competition certainly has definitely been a tremendous plus for our community. We like what we see out on the mat. We want to thank Columbia University for providing us just a beautiful facility.
Oh, it's great.
And we want to thank all those who have made a huge contribution to this event, to making this weekend a success. We have Beat the Streets, Metropolitan Wrestling Association, and of course, NYC and Company.
Perez gets an escape. He chose bottom to start the second period. So he now leads 5-0.
Time's up.
We seem to have some technical difficulties with the clock.
Looks like we're going to have a little bit of a race here between Farrell and Polly.
Well, yeah, Polly's going to have to turn it on.
They got their big guns coming up.
They do. Right now, Farrell's got a 12.5-point lead. So it's going to be interesting to see. Polly still has four shots at him. Farrell still has three guys left, or two guys left, I guess, now. So we'll see how that plays out. But it's the first close team race we've had since the first time,
absolutely.
When Horace Mann won the first one.
That's right.
First two, actually.
Yeah, and you see a program like Monsignor Farrell. There's been a program that's been number one in New York City for so many years, but it's nice to see some of these other programs step up, compete with them, and make this a three-team, four-team race.
Absolutely, and that's the way it should be. And I think you're going to see as some of these teams get better, some of the traditionally good teams are really starting to come back.
Right.
And strong Cottonville, Martin Luther. Martin Luther went through some time where,
yeah,
you wouldn't see too many of their guys in the place matches,
but
we've seen a number of them this year.
Yeah, this year we're excited. We had three places. It took a 2, 3, and a 5. We entered in addition to that, two of our wrestlers were underclassmen, a 7th and 2 8th graders. So we're excited about where that program's going and the job that Coach Moran and Coach Toro are doing.
What else is happening over at Martin Luther in general besides wrestling? It looks like, by the way, Perez goes up 7-0 with a 2-point takedown. 47 seconds left in the second period. What's happening over at Martin Luther now that you're principal? Tell us all about it.
Okay, we 2 years ago we added our middle school, starting at grade 6, and it's really been a big boost for us in terms of adding to program, but also the spirit of the school. Currently we're reaching out over the Pacific, and we're having a number of our students come from China now.
That's exciting.
It's unbelievable. We have currently, starting this semester, over 40 students from China that are attending Martin Luther High School. In addition to that, we'll be reaching out to Brazil, Germany, and I believe Korea also will be looking at Martin Luther as a possibility for their high school education. So we're excited about that. Nice.
Another takedown for Perez after Peacock had scored an escape.
And he got two.
So
did he get two? No.
Well, I guess not. No takedown. Okay, there is a two, yeah. 2-point takedown. He didn't get back points because his shoulders were over the line. 9 seconds remain in the second period.
We get a chance to talk a little about the Metropolitan Wrestling Association and all the years that they supported this event and how they provided the human resources needed and over these years to help make this a success. And we appreciate getting the opportunity to be part of this and continue to be part of wrestling in New York City.
Jim, you're the president of the Metropolitan Wrestling Association, so...
And you're the CEO.
So we have a little something to be happy about there. And yeah, we're real happy, to be part of this. We've been part of it since day one, and we've watched it grow. It's like you're watching your child grow. You know?
Absolutely. Well, I could tell. I remember the days when we first started at Luther, and with the idea of trying to get four best in each of the divisions.
Yeah.
And how we've expanded. There you go. Keep his hips down. He's good.
Yeah. Yeah. A lot of strength out on that mat right now.
Kid from King is not quitting on him. That's for sure.
And there it is. That's the fall for Perez. 25 seconds into the third period, he wins by a fall. And that'll put Eagle Academy over 100 points.
Wow. Where does that put them in the... they'll be in the top...
They're sixth.
Top six in the... Nice job.
They'll be at 102.5 points after that fall. That puts them in with the rest of the elite.
In elite.
For a small school, pretty good.
How many students at the Eagle?
Right?
How many students?
I don't know the exact number, but they are a small school.
From Hollywood, thanks to the Lindsay. From Martin Luther King, Alexander
Palmer. Here comes the defending state champion, although he won't defend his state championship this year, Adis Radoncic from Poly Prep. Wrestled for Riverdale Kingsbridge. This is his third finals, the Bears Cup finals, and he'll be wrestling Alexander Palmer from Martin Luther King. Radoncic has transferred to Poly, so he'll be competing in the prep states and national. You know a little bit about those tournaments, right?
National preps have gone on for 30, 40 years. A tremendous opportunity for New York wrestlers to get wrestling against some of the best in the nation, which include Blair Academy, Wyoming Seminary, McDonough from Maryland. New York's got an opportunity to have a representative of each of the weight classes. Adidas is certainly one of the favorites at 170 this year. He's got to qualify on February 8th at Long Island Lutheran High School as New York independent schools have their state tournament, with the champions giving the opportunity to represent the New York zone at the national preps this year.
There's a nice shot. You see how he set that up, pulled him, got a little circular motion going, and here comes the leg. Took advantage of it with his single.
Kid from King's giving him a tough time. Not giving in. It's still neutral.
Yeah. Referee is Pete Ham. He's being assisted by Billy Patton.
But 3-4 years ago, we used to compete against the New Jersey schools, Blair Academy, Benedict's, Petty, Rutgers Prep, along with the New York, to determine our zone representative. And then we were granted our own zone. New York was finally recognized as, and we were able to present at least one wrestler in each of the weight classes. We're certainly expecting some good things from our wrestlers this year. A number of our teams have now gone out of state to compete against some of these prep schools, whether it's in New Hampshire, Massachusetts, Maryland. I know Polly was down at Germantown, competed down there. Martin Luther took their travels up to Mount North Hermon in Massachusetts and competed against Mount North Hermon, St. Paul's, Exeter. Long Island Lutheran also did that. So we're looking to expand to get ourselves some competition outside the New York region in addition to our foes around here. But I'm really excited about this year. I think we have some of our best opportunities in quite some time as New York to place well at the tournament and put New York back on the map.
Well, we're 15 seconds into the second period here, and Radoncic only has a 1-point lead. He had an escape from the, he chose bottom and had an escape.
So he likes that little Metzger thing.
A little bit of a surprise to you?
You know, I saw Martin Luther King kid wrestle, a Martin Luther wrestler, Alex Ortiz, in the semis. Look, he's a slow starter, but I'll tell you, at the end of that third period, he put it on.
Yeah.
And really shows he's got quite a bit of technique there. He certainly, he's got the wherewithal to stay with this kid, hopefully in three periods, but we'll see. This kid's not a state champ for no reason.
That's for sure. And he finished second in the Eastern States, where he lost to another state champion. No takedown.
That was just 2 weeks ago, right?
There's a real good chance that the top three placements in that will wind up being the New York State Division I, Division II, and the Prep School National Champions. It could all happen.
Wow. That was quite a tournament. And there was, 32 wrestlers in that bracket?
At least. There might have been more.
Wow. Teams from California were invited.
They won it. Team from Clovis West in California won the tournament.
And I know Polly brought three, maybe four of their wrestlers to that tournament. The level of competition there is just phenomenal. Thank the people that served food this whole weekend. Did you?
Oh, yeah. No, we...
We had...
One of the great things about the Mayor's Cup is the concession stand, the food concession stand.
And what about Al Belvoir in New York, the USA Wrestling?
Yeah.
They came out, Beat the Streets USA.
Beat the Streets USA Wrestling.
And they provide us with some gear to the...
Gear and a bunch of stuff. So, we're looking forward to working with Al on the Beat the Streets USA program moving forward from here. And we start to reach out to some cities, urban areas outside of New York City, and help them develop some wrestling as well. New Jersey, upstate New York, Connecticut.
Yeah.
And who knows how far. The Fischetti family that owns the catering service here, Cara Fischetti, they just do a terrific job with it.
You know, did they have some wrestlers back in the day over at Monsignor Farrell?
Yeah. One of the wrestlers who is now coaching in Cottonville.
Wow. Yeah, it's interesting. You see a lot of former wrestlers now taking on the responsibility of coaching. It's how I started. I got an opportunity to wrestle at Martin Luther, and then I was given an opportunity to be an assistant and work my way up to the head coaching ranks. But I see a lot of that, and as you spend a number of years in the sport, you can see other schools, and you see some of the coaching staff or former wrestlers that are just wanting to give it back to their programs. And wrestling's one of those sports that kids who've gone through the ranks, put in the dirty work, are willing to come back and help and develop young talent in their room because they just have a love for the sport.
Getting back to this match, we got a minute to go, and it's tied. We're now tied at one with a minute to go.
Wow. Is this third period?
It's the third period.
Yeah. Brad's certainly not happy with that, Paul.
Be the head coach? Go back to the table. Not the head coach.
So a little discussion as to the Lance Fleury.
We got blood time on King.
Blood time on
Martin Luther King.
That's Alexander Palmer over there, a little bit of a nosebleed.
Okay. Once he's got that control, the clock will stop.
Actually, they're running the blood time. It appears for the wrong guy.
Yeah, it does seem okay, you just make sure that goes on red, not green. Yeah, do you put the red time? You put blood time.
Yeah. I just got a message from John Zarconi, who's watching this on our broadcast from up in Portland. Yeah, it was Vin Fischetti, was a two-time champion here and a fifth at the New York State Championship. It's his family that runs the catering for us here, and they did a terrific job.
I guess they fed him well, because he, so he's got the credentials. All right, now we have 26 seconds left in this match.
And it's tied at one.
This
is quite a surprise, I think.
King's not giving in. He's certainly putting the pressure.
There's a takedown with 7 seconds left.
Looks like he's got himself a W.
And that's it.
Nice takedown. He was relentless. He wasn't going to let it. He wanted to get it done in the third. Kip King is tough.
Yeah.
He was no wall grower, so.
Well, that was a bit of a partner. Unexpected. Now we're going to move to 113. Noah Malamut from Poly Prep and Nolan McColgan from Patrides. This could be quite a match.
I know Malamut. He's a defending New York State private school champion. I think two-time. Nice job. I have no idea. I haven't seen this kid from Patrides.
He's been around. He was, I believe he was a defending champion from 99 pounds from last year.
Wow.
I believe both of these wrestlers are defending champions.
That's true. I think I'm presenting awards.
I think probably after this match we'll be able to get Lou back in here. So
Lou is stepping up. There you go. He's got another match on his clipboard. All right, he's got another. Lou joined the Poly staff 2 years
yeah.
2 years ago, correct?
Yeah. Yeah. This is his second season there.
After many at Farrell, he went across the river.
Got an updated team score here. Getting a little bit closer up at the top. We've got Poly Prep now with 158. Farrell at 166 and a half. Following that win by Radon Cheech. And so they're closing the gap a little bit.
There you go. These points are new. It's a big 4 points for Poly to pick up and then some. Taking an early 2-0 lead.
Had a number of guys, including both of these wrestlers, who have been representing the state of New York at the Junior Nationals out in Fargo in the summer. There were quite a few of them in the finals here that were part of that. So both of these wrestlers were on the Fargo team, yeah.
Second from Martin Luther King, that's Noel Peacock. And your 2020 Mayor Chuck Jacob from Eagle Academy.
Tom Favell is our referee. He's been assisted by George Cabrales.
A little bit about Tom. Tom used to coach at Long Island Lutheran High School back in the 80s. My arch nemesis. Tom and I had some real good duels over the years. He led Long Island Lutheran to state tournament championship, team championship, while he was at Lehigh. Had a number of prep school, New York State prep school champions. And when he stepped down, I believe he's now working at the Herrick School. and he took on officiating. And he's one of the lead officials in the New York City area.
Refereed the state tournament several times.
And he's going to be representing the New York zone at the National Preps.
That's great.
Yep. He was nominated along with Rich Rinaldi.
Fantastic. So they'll be working out at the National Preps at Lehigh?
At Lehigh. One of the efforts that we've made is to have representation from all zones, and that it wasn't just predominantly a Maryland or a Pennsylvania flavor to the officiating. And we've gotten the opportunity, the nominations went in, and they accepted the two of the individuals to work this year at Lehigh University. So we're excited about that. They get an opportunity to show their craft and represent New York.
While we were discussing that, Malamud scored a two-point near fall. It goes up by a score of 4-0 with about 20 seconds left in the first period.
Hold on, it's got potentially dangerous.
Hey, set! Bring back, let's go!
Potentially dangerous call. Stood up with that arm bar. I guess he felt that the bottom man had no way to defend himself if they were to come back to the mat with any kind of force.
What year is the Petrides kid?
Senior. He's a senior.
Senior. So is Noah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so we go into the second period. The score is Malamud from Pali Prep 4 and McColgan from Petrides 0. Malamud wins the toss but defers his choice to the third period, and McColgan chooses the neutral position. Hogan's long, isn't he?
Yeah. It's going to be tough for Noah to get under, but he's doing a good job. He's just working underneath those zones. Now, in the next 2 weeks, people are getting ready to be qualifiers, and whether it's the New York City qualifier for the states, New York independent schools, and also the Catholic schools are coming up with a state qualifier.
Reaching that end of the season already.
Yeah,
it's
my
amazing
goodness.
How fast it went by, isn't it?
Yes.
McColgan's in on a nice deep single here. Malam is defending pretty well.
Scramble out.
Without a score.
Long Island Lutheran's going to be hosting New York Independent Prep Tournament on February 8th. We'll have about 13 schools represented in the New York area. I think the Catholic schools will be the same
the
weekend.
Same weekend, they go on the 8th and the 9th.
And where are they going to be holding it?
They also have it on Long Island at Chaminade.
Okay, wow. Nice.
Actually, they're the following weekend, I believe.
Oh, 16? The cities?
Yeah, city championships from the PSAL.
Malamud got a warning, backing out. Deep, deep. Double. Falling up, that's
like
nice.
Down. There you go. Element now leads 6-0. Getting close to those potential bonus points that Pali really needs right now.
Yeah, to get that 8-pointer, the difference would be helpful. They'll give him another, half point, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, another half, a major decision. They'll give him a half point for tournament scoring.
That's correct. I rely on the computer so much.
much to do the scoring for me nowadays, so I have to really think back as to what the actual points are.
Are you doing Federation scoring on this, or are we doing state? Okay, Federation scoring, that means Tech Falls are 1.5, right?
Yeah.
Unlike the state scoring when they go, don't they go at a full pin on the Tech Fall?
No, not anymore.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So they finally agreed on something. They're going into the third period.
Okay, we're going to go into the third period. Melman from Poly Prep is leading 6-0. He chooses the bottom position, so he's going to put himself in position to get those bonus points. A reversal here would do it.
Stand up.
Well, we have two of America's Olympians in the house.
Nice draw.
I don't know who. Who do you think's here? I'll give you the years. 1996 and 1952.
96 would be Kendall.
Yeah, Kendall Cross is here.
Kendall Cross. And he's going to be one of the award presenters.
Andy Fitch? Yeah, Andy Fitch is here. He comes every year to the finals.
Okay. 52 Olympian?
Yeah, part of the New York Athletic Club.
Now that scores a reversal here, to get kind of...
How did he get that? We got a point there someplace.
We got a illegal slam. Yep. Nice little switch.
That makes that bonus even that much more achievable.
The standing area right now, the 170-pound individual person ready to be presented with their awards. The presenter is S.A.L. Assigner. P.S.A.L. Assigner of officials, Mr. Larry Cantor.
Got to back out, back out, back out.
Six from Mark Luther, Alex Ortiz.
Alabama is out for an escape, so
he's got his 8 points.
You got a minute and a half to go for Nolan McCulligan to try to get that point back.
Where's Matridis in this race?
Number
11.
11, they have a chance to get into the top 10. A win here for Patrice would put them in the top 10.
That's for sure. Nope. All right, so spin around. He's got two.
Point take out. Now you can start to think about the possibility of a tech ball.
Tech ball.
He's got plenty of time with the minute, a little better than a minute to go. He's got a couple of points to play with if he decided he wanted to cut them.
Yep. Tilt. He's going to get points.
I don't know if he had two. Yeah,
he got two.
He's got two. If he can, smart move here might be to give up this hold and go for another one. He's better off letting him go, I think, now. Not let him go, but let him go of that hold so he gets his 2 points and get a new one.
There he goes. He got his two now. They get a three here. He gets three here. Nah, it's too high.
It wasn't a very tight cradle.
No. It's a little high on that.
This is a crucial couple of seconds we got left here. This could be critical in the team race.
Much needed points.
Points. 10 seconds remain. He's got He's got a cradle again.
He's going to jam it.
He's got a cradle.
Walk it over.
He doesn't have enough time to get the... Okay, so with a 12-0 decision, Noah Malamut becomes our champion. At 113 pounds. And that tightens that team race even a little bit more. It's now a 4-point lead. Jim, thanks for being with us. President of the MWA, principal of Martin Luther High School, founder of the Mayor's Cup. Great to have you with us here. Hey, did you know the Mayor's Cup has only had one four-time champion in its history? He's sitting right next to us here. Hey, while we're waiting, say hi to Ben Villaret. Ben, what do you think? A little different than it used to be?
Yeah, definitely. The competition's tougher. It looks like it's gotten a lot more deep. It's pretty good.
And Ben's a wrestler here at Columbia himself right now, so he's limping around a little bit. Got hurt in the tournament last week, so we're wishing him well. We've got to let him go back to scorekeeping. But our only four-time champion, four times, the only one ever in the history of this tournament, Ben Villaret. Great to see you, Ben. While we were there, we were presenting the Team Sportsmanship Award, which is given by the officials every year. It's presented this year to St. Joseph's by the Sea High School from Staten Island. Okay, we're going to move to the big guys now, 285. We've got Mazen Hassan from Farrell and Anad Munkjargal from James Madison. What do you think? I'm joined again by Joe DeForti Jr. So what do you think, Joe? What do you think?
Well, I like Mazen in this match, but you never know. Farrell really needs this match to keep the lead in this tournament if they want to edge out Poly here. Big major decision by Noah in that match.
That was huge. That extra point. We got a 3.5-point lead right now for Farrell.
So this one will come down to the wire. So they're going to need every win they can get.
It sure is. And each of them has two wrestlers remaining. So Polly's going to have to win both, and Farrell's going to have to win one, and then we'll see what happens with the bonus points. Farrell wins both, of course, and the bonus points are relatively equal, and then Farrell will keep the lead. But this is the closest this tournament has ever been. It's kind of exciting for the fans.
And they have some tough matches coming up, too. Lukey wrestling, John Luke wrestling a good kid from Cardoza, Gonzalez, and Adam Gonzalez, and Gomez, I'm sorry. Barry wrestling Saeed. Saeed Karama from New Utrecht. So.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting, to say the least. And first,
currently being presented at the station here as the individual award at the 113-pound weight class. An aid from Martin Luther King, Taylor Hogan.
Mason has a body lock, looking for a Merkel.
Six for the age to Mark Rivers. Fifth for the age to O'Donoghue.
Fourth, out of bounds.
Third, both need to get close to the lead. Okay, so we had a little scramble there, but to no avail. Nobody scored any points. 40 seconds remain in the first period. No score.
Both of them equal here, college ties, and uh,
It's a classic heavyweight match, right?
Yeah.
A lot of collar ties, a lot of pushing and shoving. Yeah. One guy waiting for an opportunity.
Yeah. Looking for body locks, headlocks.
Such. The gap is closed with 3.5. Monsignor Farrell leads Molly Prep 166.5 to 163.
They were just announcing to the crowd about the team score, a 3.5-point lead for Farrell.
We'll go into the second period scoreless.
If I remember correctly, this kid's got a pretty good side roll. I think I remember seeing that in the match that I refereed with these guys.
Well, that'll be fun to see.
He's going to try to stand up anyway.
Yeah. Tripod there. Mason's in the crotch and trying to extend him. And he faces him.
There's an escape there for Renan.
I'll put him up 1-0. With about a minute and 40 to go. Now trying to hit a duck under there. Almost successful. Once again, back in that heavy. Mason gets a front headlock there and trying to circle.
Fought it off pretty good there.
Yeah. Now, and it turns out it was nothing. So with about a minute 50 left, well, with about 50 seconds left, we're one nothing Muzunaki. Mason's got an underhook here.
Congratulations on being a city placement here, being all city, huh?
Yeah, that was great. It was a good first showing at Mayor's Cup.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of good kids in my bracket, wrestled a lot of good matches. I was just happy to be a part. And
time runs out on
Mason on his attempt to score.
So let's see what he chooses. Of course he chooses bottom. Yeah. You might expect.
Yeah. Crowd didn't like it. They've been very into it in these championship runs. Muzunaki goes right to an ankle. Trying to elevate it. Now he's out front on a leg. Mason's trying to face him.
He's got to be careful there. Okay, he takes him out of bounds.
Muzunaki still got control here. Muzunaki on that leg again. Mason's trying to stand up.
He can only do that so long. He's going to get
Look for a stall there. And Mason's away, and now we're tied in the final.
We're tied in the third period.
Yep. Big win.
The dance continues.
Yep. Big win if Foul can get it. Both wrestlers showing fatigue here. With a minute left in this third period to win the city championship here.
Yeah.
Crowd getting really into it now.
Oh yeah. Oh, I know how critical these points are for Farrell.
Yeah,
and you know, Poly fans are just as massive here.
Yeah. Stalling on red. Stalling called on Mason.
No, it was called on
Fujinagi?
Yes, Mason's got the green ankle, man.
So that puts Mason up 2-1.
14 seconds left to go.
Yeah.
Hard to argue with that call. Mason was moving forward most of the match.
Yeah. It's just hard to call these 285 pounders. Not a lot of shots.
And that'll do it.
Moving there. Looks like Mason's going to be our 2013 Mayor's Cup champion at the 285 weight class.
Now Polly's going to really need the bonus points. Yeah, if they're going to get it back into this thing, they're going to need bonus points. It's got to be more than just a win.
Yeah. And that'll put Farrell up by 6 now. So they'll need a pin or they'll need 2 wins.
Actually, they'll put them up by 7.5. They get 4 points for that win. So that's why the bonus points become critical.
Yeah. They'll need both DiStefano and Barry to win this if they want to win this tournament.
Now they've met before, these two, this year.
In the Garden. I think John Luke pins Gomez in the first period.
And Gomez, on the other hand, won a couple matches up in New York State last year, so he's a defending city champion.
So, yes, he's now...
This could be a great match.
Yeah. He was third last year. John Luke took third at this tournament last year.
As an eighth grader?
Yeah. Polly, you're allowed to start a year earlier. Both wrestlers come out aggressive. And they're out of bounds. Gomez, very athletic and all over the place wrestler. Both wrestlers pounding on their tie-ups. Snapped down by John Luke. Luke, he's got a leg, but he's dropped to his hip. Now he's basing up and trying to turn. Cut the corner on that leg. Gomez wrapped both of their legs are wrapped around, and Gomez gets 2.
Take that nice counter by Gomez.
DiStefano running around the corner there. Gomez defended well. With a tight waist, trying to roll up a wrist. He's got to get off the hips, though. Now DiStefano's basing up here. Trying to get out, sits out, kept down.
Warning for stalling against Gomez.
That was a warning on crowd.
It was a stall warning on Gomez as well. Polly tried to make the call, I think, before the referee had a chance, but he made it anyway.
So 33 seconds left in this match, left in this period. DiStefano tries to clear that arm. Gomez flattens him out. And that's one for DiStefano. Tries to get on a shot quick.
Okay, with 14 seconds to go in the first period, it's 2-1 for Gomez. Both these guys are quick, huh?
Yeah. Well, that's what happens when you get to the lower weights.
Yeah.
A lot faster. Especially compared to that last match. Gomez. And that'll end the first period. Gomez up 2-1. Stefano wins the coin toss. And chooses to defer. Gomez is going down now.
Bottom. I thought for a second he was going to choose neutral. That would have made it interesting.
Yeah. But coaches say no. And the second period started. Lukey coming out aggressive, trying to break him down.
It's all about hips right now.
Yeah.
All about hips.
Yeah.
Whose hips get higher?
Yeah.
This could go either way. This could be back points for John Luke, or it could be a reversal for Gomez.
Luke trying to get under him.
Interesting
getting
position.
Getting a crotch lock here.
Yeah, be careful. He doesn't get rocked up onto his shoulders.
Yeah. Defensively pinned. Gomez trying to elevate that leg.
And he comes out of it.
And it looks like nothing will happen here. He's got a leg in, and they're going back down.
Plenty of time left, minute and 10 seconds left in the period.
Both wrestlers tangled up.
It's only a matter of time before it looked like a stalemate had in the works.
He was looking for it. That was a little exciting.
Yeah.
Lukey goes right with the leg in. And it's kicked out by Gomez. Now he's prying in the crotch, looking for a half. Lukey's right up. And he drops to a leg. Gomez trying to face him.
Here we go again.
Those ankles. Here we go.
Crazy positions.
Scrambles. Lukey trying to seatbelt him.
Again to go in.
And now it looks like... And a reversal for Gomez. He'll go up 4-1 now. With 19 seconds left in the period. And they're out of bounds.
9 seconds. This could be a critical 9 seconds. One point here can make all the difference in the world. John Luke DiStefano jumped a little bit on that one. So.
Yeah, a little excited there. Another caution. Clock difficulties there.
A little trouble with the clock there.
Yeah. Trying to get up with 3 seconds left. He's on his feet. One. And cannot face him in time. So it'll be 4-1 going into the third period here. John Luke chooses bottom, obviously.
Tight, come in, tight.
Gomez staying on his hips there, trying to work a gable bar. Poly coaches pleading for a stall warning on Gomez.
Gomez has a cradle locked up now.
Now he's looking to stud it here. Mookie flattened himself on the mat. As time ticks away on the clock.
Minute left, a little less than a minute left now. He got out of that cradle though, so he's got a shot.
And a stall warning on Red. Stall warning on DeStefano now. Seconds left here. DeStefano stands up and he's trying to get up again. He's got,
if he gets that wrist, he's got a shot.
He's got a pee and he's trying to roll with it.
He's
got to
get his butt down and his head up. He's in business
and he's looking for a roll here with 26 seconds left.
Lost the wrist there. It's gonna make it
tough. Lost that leg now with 15 seconds left. They'll hit him with a pencil. They'll hit Gomez with a potentially dangerous and go back on bottom. John Luke flat on the mat now.
Looks like 5 seconds to go, and looks like Gomez is going to take this Mayor's Cup Championship at 106 pounds. So by a score of 4-1, Gomez wins.
Tough flat match by both wrestlers.
Oh, there's two very good wrestlers out there.
Yeah.
Next up, our 14th final of the day, the 126-pound Mayor's Cup final, from Monsignor
Farrell,
Matthew Seitz, and from
Fort Brett, Chris Martorello. So we go down to 126. Matthew Seitz from Monsignor Farrell, and Chris Martorello from Fordham Prep. Paul Boscia is your referee. Rich Rinaldi will be his assistant.
Chris Martorello, Fordham Prep. Season record of 30-5 with 112 career victories. This year he is a third place at Shoreline.
Well, this could pretty much ice it for Farrell.
Yeah, with a win here, that'll clinch. That'll clinch a tournament championship here.
Certainly would.
Martello shoots in, Seitz gets a front headlock, and is trying to spin around and get two, and he will.
There's a two-point takedown.
Immediately throws in a leg. Try to elevate it and turn, Chris. He's got a leg and a bar in. And they're out of bounds. Minute left in the period, Seitz up 2-0. Seitz trying to roll up an arm there. He's got a tight waist and he's flattening Chris out. Throwing in a leg, elevating an ankle. Chris trying to face him here.
working that leg really well.
Yeah.
Combining it with a lot of different things in there, and that's the secret to riding legs, is being able to combine it with what you're doing with the rest of his body. You know?
Yeah, there's just so much you can do with a leg, or two in. You're controlling his hips, so you can hit halves, bars, Jacob's hooks, anything.
Once again, the 106-pound individual plays for us to the staging area, please.
Sights trying to get a bar in there.
10 seconds remain in the first period. Okay, so we go to the second period. Sights leads 2-0.
Sights getting the choice and choosing bottom. Tries to get to crab right there. And Seitz will face him and reverse him.
He's got two and he's gonna get some back points as well.
Might even get a pin. Trying to circle around his head here.
Near fall.
So I make it 6-0 Sights with about a minute and 20 seconds left in the second period. Once again with those legs. Now with a minute left in the second period.
Is that leg again?
Yeah. Sights really riding Martinello very well in this match. And they'll stand up and they'll call it potentially dangerous. 50 seconds left in the match.
Down to 30 seconds left in the second period, and
Sights
pretty dominant here.
Yeah, Sights looking for a turn now. Martlow might get a reversal though, and he's got a Turk on the legs and is working up the body, and we'll just hold the Turk until the end of the pack. Chops, breaks up that arm, headlocks him, gets that leg in again, and 3-2-1. And
that'll bring us to the third period. Sights up 6-0. Chooses neutral.
Martlow shoots in, he's got a drag on that arm, and Sights shoots in on a sweep, dumping him, arm drag, and he's got two now on the edge of the mat.
coming down to a minute left to go. Sites with an 8-0 lead. That'll be bonus points for Farrell as well if he maintains that 8-point differential. And
facing each other, getting in a little scramble here.
Yeah. We have an injury here. We have
Chris hurt his knee a little bit here.
Monterello hurt his knee. That knee was covered to begin with. So.
Yeah. Trainers come out, check on his knee, and it looks like he'll be fine.
Third from Grace High School, Louis Grant. Second from Holly Brett, Jamie Estefan. 2014 Mayor's Cup champion, 106 pounds, from Edgar Cardo, Adam Gomez. Gomez.
So with a minute and 6 seconds left in the period, Sites is up 8-0. Comes out on top, chopping him down. He's out front now with a headlock.
Well, he works that well, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Controlling the elbow the way you're supposed to. Not losing position, knowing exactly when to reach.
Very technically sound wrestler. Sites a sophomore this year, so he's got 2 years ahead of him after this.
There have only been three-time champions in the history of the Mayor's Cup. One four-time champion.
Ben Villaret.
Yeah, sitting right next to you.
And with 10 seconds left in this match, looks like Matt Sites is going to win.
My question remaining is by how much, and that's it. 8-0. Get the match now that we've been sort of waiting for all day long.
Yeah.
Saeed Kakramanov and Jake Barry. Final match, which might have had some real implications on the team score, actually won't. Our referee is Billy Patton, assisted by Richie Martinez.
They'll come out aggressive. Farrell clinching the Mayor's Cup victory after that last match by Sites. He's locking up on that arm, trying to get a drag. Both wrestlers attempting shots, and Saeed's in on one. He's got a leg locked up. Barry's trying to whiz her out, and he won't get it. Now Saeed's got a leg and could get some back points here. Barry trying to fight off his back. Saeed's got that arm locked up around the neck, though.
That's going to be hard to get off, but he's got a lot of them. He's got a minute left in this period.
Saeed trying to slow down the pace here.
Saeed's a state place winner from last year, too. He's sixth in the New York State Championships. That's it. That'll be the fall. We'll be back with some awards presentations. Joe, thanks so much for being part of this broadcast.
Thank you for having me.
You did a terrific job.
Thank you.
And
2014 Mayor's Cup champion, 138 pounds, Steve Cardano. Ladies and gentlemen, we ask that you stick around to present the awards in the 126 and 138 pounds individual categories.
I don't know. Yeah. No, that's what you're going to do. And we'll be back in just a minute with the team awards. We're going to give you our final team scores here. Final team scores for the top six teams. Eagle Academy finishes with 108.5 points. Martin Luther King finishes with 116.5 points. Tottenville finishes with 127 points, winning the overall PSAL championship, the Jim Regan Award. It's Brooklyn Tech with 142.5 points. They finish in third place overall. That was the Larry Cantor PSAL Award. Winning the Jim Regan Award with 163 points for the highest scoring private school is Poly Prep. Winning both the overall championship and the Bob Legalkin highest scoring Catholic School Award, Monsignor Farrell with 175.5. Thank you, everybody, for joining us here at the Columbia University for the 11th annual Mayor's Cup Championship. Look forward to having you here again next year.